I posted that video a few days ago, and I've gotten a lot of response from students asking, what was that stuff you did in the ending? That was a pretty cool chord progression stuff. What's going on there? So I decided I'm gonna shoot a video to explain all of that theory behind those chord progressions I did at the ending, so stay tuned. Welcome, welcome back, folks. It's the season to be jolly. Merry Christmas when it comes. From now on out, I'm just going to be doing some Christmas songs and stuff like that. So if you're into that stuff, there's going to be more coming your way. And hey, if you're new to the channel and you're loving the content that we're posting, be sure to hit that subscribe button and the thumbs up so that you can be notified when I post more Christmas videos like this that will be coming in a few days and a few weeks from now. So, what did I do in this ending, this beautiful ending of O Holy Night? Let's jump into it. So, I'm playing in the key of E flat. E flat major. So let's talk about the chords, and then I'll go back and talk to you about the theory behind the chords. So the song goes, behold your king, behold. And then I did a So those are the chords I use. When I get to that five, and I do this nice little walk up. Five sus. Resolving the five, then. You know this chord already. It's an A flat major chord in first inversion with just the add nine. Then, B flat major chord, first inversion. Or I have the third in the bass. So, now instead of going to the giant one, I decided I'm going to do a little bit of a deceptive cadence. So I went to the sharp five, which is B major, right? Actually, let me get into a B major nine. So all of that beautiful stuff going. This is where we get into what is known as modal mixture, right? A mixing mode. Because B major comes from the parallel minor of E flat, which is E flat minor. That's E flat harmonic minor, even though I'm playing in the key of E flat major. So I went to the sharp five or flat six, depending on how you want to look at it. So one of the things a lot of people generally do is that's a common ending. And again, they're just doing to flat six or sharp five, flat seven to one. And those chords are borrowed from the harmonic or the harmonic minor ski, right? So the diatonic chords of E flat harmonic minor, right? And then you can go, and then. Or sometimes you can blend the harmonic minor with the natural minor, so then you might get, you might introduce that B flat. Now B major, and then the, or the, so So you can blend the harmonic minor and the natural, the natural minor, not the melodic. So harmonic minor and the natural minor. You can borrow chords from those keys, parallel keys, oftentimes when you're playing. So all I did was to go to that B, then the two, and this is the two in E flat minor, F minor 7 flat 5. That's the chord right there. The two chord in E flat minor. And then I went to my five, maintaining the same notes of that F diminished or minor 7 flat 5 chord. So that gives me now a B flat 7 sus 4 flat 9, really. Because I have the flat 9, I have my sus 4, I have my 7. And then I just resolve that to a flat 9 chord. And then resolution to my E flat major 13th. And that's the ending right there. So, behold your King, behold the lowly, you know? And so while you're on that B, major 7 or major 9, you have some option now to play around with some fills and some lines. So again, because this chord, the B is a chord pulled from the minor scale, all I'm doing now is playing notes of this E flat minor scale over it. Can go on and on, right? So now there are two things you can do. You can play the E flat harmonic minor scale over this B major 7. But the reason I refrain from doing that, it can work. I don't like this minor third going to major third thing here. So then I switch it to the natural minor, which includes the C sharp. Sounds better to my ears. Right? You can also think about it as B Lydian. And the Lydian mode is derived from F sharp, the fourth mode of F sharp. So all of these you see are tied in because E flat minor is also the relative minor for F sharp major. Or you could say D sharp minor is relative minor for F sharp. So it all ties in, and that's why it doesn't really matter which note you start on. Once you play that B, you can start on any note from the key. Now when I get to my two, that's when I switch to the harmonic minor. Right? And you can still play that harmonic minor when you're on the B flat. Resolve to the major 13th. So, that's it. That's all I have for you. Short tutorial today. That's the ending I did in the video. Now, I did a lot of other cool chord changes and progression in that entire video that I recorded, and I have shot a course on it. I've shot a beginner's version, an intermediate version, and an intermediate advanced version of the course, explaining everything that I did. So, this progression that I did right here. A star sweetly gleaming. Here come wise men from the Orient land. Whoa, crazy stuff, huh? What's going on there? A lot of other sort of cool modal mixture stuff happening, and I break that down in the tutorial available right now over at Piano Lesson with Warren. You can go over there and access it. I have MIDI file, I have the backing track, and I have scores outlining everything that I played. So if you read music, you can jump in and start to dive into that easily as well. Right now, that course is available over in the membership area at pianolessonwithwarren.com. So, are you a member? If you're not a member of Piano Lesson with Warren yet, you're doing yourself a disservice. I make it so that it's easy for you to compress 6 months of headache into 1 month of work. That's all I do for you guys. I move all the nonsense out of the way and show you exactly what you need to learn and how you need to learn it so you can speed up the rate at which you learn piano by ear. All right, so head over to Piano Lesson with Warren and check that out. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button over here as well so you can stay up to date with the content that we release over here. All right, so until then, keep listening, keep singing, keep practicing, and I'll catch you next week for another tutorial. Bye for now.